Hi, in this video newsletter, I want to talk to you about a very important study that was published in 2010, looking at the role of B vitamins and their ability to help to preserve normal cognitive function of the brain. So the study known as the Oxford Project to investigate memory and aging was published in 2010 in an online journal, Public Library of Science 1, by D. Smith and fellow researchers from Oxford University. Now what they did is they had a study group of 168 individuals who were over 70 years of age who had mild cognitive impairment. That meant that they were sort of slipping in terms of their mental faculties. And they gave half the group a supplementation cocktail of B vitamins, folic acid, 800 micrograms, vitamin B12, 500 micrograms, and vitamin B6, 20 milligrams. And they took that cocktail every day. And the other group got the placebo product, which had, you know, the dummy pill had nothing in it. And what they saw, the main outcome was this. They measured the change in the rate of whole brain shrinkage or whole brain atrophy using MRI scans. And what they saw was striking, that on average, the group that took the B vitamins showed that they had slowed the rate of brain atrophy by 30%. These are people that already had cognitive decline to begin with, so it started to slow down the rate at which the brains were shrinking or undergoing atrophy. In some cases, the reductions were as high as 53%. And they saw there was a greater rate of atrophy was associated with lower cognitive test scores. So the more the brain was shrinking, and the more atrophy, as we call it, we're also seeing a decline in mental faculties, so there seemed to be a one-to-one relationship. So the question is, why would they even study B vitamins? Well, we know that folic acid, NB6, and vitamin B12 help to lower a very dangerous chemical in the bloodstream called homocysteine. Homocysteine can damage blood vessels in the brain, which can then in turn affect blood flow to certain parts of the brain. So by lowering the toxic chemical homocysteine by giving B vitamins, the homocysteine levels go down, and the brain damage is minimized. That's sort of how it works. Because we know that higher homocysteine levels in previous studies have been associated with, you know, more brain atrophy. And in this study as well, we saw the same thing. And B vitamins are also required to make certain brain chemicals called neurotransmitters that allow your brain to function and think and for you to have normal memory and recall and alertness. And so that's why they chose the B vitamins, folic acid, B6, and B12. Now, in the normal aging process, we know that in the elderly, the brain shows some progressive atrophy. So there's atrophy occurring, even in cognitively healthy people, but it's much more accelerated in patients that, say, have Alzheimer's disease. And there's an intermediate rate of atrophy which occurs in people that have mild cognitive impairment. So after the age of 60, and this is sort of the aging question here, is that after the age of 60, even people without mild cognitive impairment, even who seem to be normal, the brain is still shrinking at a rate of 0.5% each year. People that have mild cognitive impairment, their brain is shrinking by about 1% per year. And people with Alzheimer's disease, you see that once they have it, the brain is actually shrinking or atrophying at a rate of 2.5% per year, that the whole brain shrinkage is 2.5% per year or greater. So because we see that B vitamins can be part of a role in slowing this process down and maintaining better cognitive function and lowering homocysteine, I'll tell you what my advice is. Every day throughout all of adult life, take a high potency multiple vitamin that has extra antioxidants and a B50 complex. Now, I created one for Adiva called the Adiva multivitamin. It has the extra antioxidants, the B50 complex. Doesn't matter how you get those nutrients in there, you should have them every day. And a lifetime intake of essential fatty acids as well, with flaxseed, borage seed, and fish seed oil, all in one, nature's essential oils. If you look at the Adiva website, you'll see that one. That's an example of a very good essential oil that gives the brain the essential oils to decrease brain inflammation. And some of those fats have been associated with reduction in risk of Alzheimer's disease as you age as well. And eat fish twice a week. After the age of 55, think about taking a memory support complex, and I created one for Adiva, and you can go and learn about that online if you like. What are the other things to know about to prevent your brain from getting damaged as you get older? Things you have control over? Watch your alcohol consumption. Alcohol kills brain cells. And recreational drugs, of course, the same thing. Smoking damages brain cells. A high animal fat diet is going to clog up your arteries in your brain, less blood flow. You're going to have more trouble as you get older. You have cholesterol inside the artery wall. You need to exercise to keep the blood flow to the brain and good sleep habits. Now, other studies have shown in terms of other activities you can do that are really important to keep the nerve circuits alive in the brain so they don't atrophy. Take dance lessons, play ping pong, any whole body movement with eye-hand coordination, badminton, learn a musical instrument, challenge your brain in a new way, learn a foreign language as an example. Do something that's outside of the normal intellectual task that you normally would do. So for me, because I read a lot of nutrition and biochemistry journals, I need to challenge my brain in a different way as I get older with something that's not in that particular genre, so that it's not just using the same nerve circuits and just expanding it, but trying to do something that's completely different to keep your brain challenged and the nerve circuits moving in the right direction. So that combination of lifestyle with supplementation and the right diet and the right activity program can do a lot to help protect your brain as you get older. I hope you'll heed this advice, and thanks so much for watching.